In tonight's cover story, it's a game that got its start right here in the city of Chicago. Some have been playing 16-inch softball for more than 60 years, and many of them now share a distinct feature, one that proves their love for a sport that's hands down a local favorite.
Ball's in.
On any given evening,
yes, 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 go, go, go!
In any given park,
safe!
You'll likely find a game of 16-inch softball, and it comes with its own badge of honor.
That's years and years of
softball abuse.
You can jam your finger pretty bad. I have two dysfunctional fingers.
Jammed, broken, or bent, crooked fingers are part of the game. And while the ladies in this league wear mitts, it's tradition for the guys, no gloves. Louis Alarcon has been playing for 25 years, and he has the hands to show for it.
Top of my finger went dislocated to the left side, and so I just gave it to the pitcher, and then I went in because they put it back in place and tape it up.
Well, people don't realize, but softball started here in Chicago at Farragut Yacht Club. All of softball. So if you're playing 12-inch, any kind of softball you play started here in Chicago. This is a replica of the first boxing glove. It was tied up and using a broomstick, not a bat, but a broomstick, and they played inside, indoors.
Longtime player and team manager Ron Kubicki walked us through the history. It's all on display at the 16-inch Softball Museum in Forest Park.
This is the official clincher, which is what we use today.
The items are Chicago gems. And so are these guys. They're Hall of Famers.
Ray Tops, I was inducted in 2001.
You can see mine right here.
I'm right here, Austin Spider Ware, inducted 2010.
Austin Spider Ware is a retired Chicago police officer. Known as a big hitter, he's been playing 16-inch since 1962.
We were playing the street back then. Back then, it wasn't a lot of cars, you know. I mean, so we could almost play two or three innings before a car came, you know. I love it.
And that love for the game far surpasses their love for their own fingers.
It's part of the game. It's part of the game.
Just play the game and you love it and you don't think about how hard the ball is. That's the least of your worries. You're worried about what's a guy going to do.
I play four nights a week, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and I play doubleheaders on Sunday.
Bill Kavanaugh isn't in the Hall of Fame, but his wife of 45 years should be.
There's a negotiation every spring for how many nights I get to play, and so it's a new car or it's new living room furniture.
He started playing at age 7, and now at nearly 70, he has a few classic battle scars of his own.
I've had a couple of injuries here. You know, this one, I just can't. It's those balls that are hit up here and over here, and you're kind of diving for balls. That's where I've had my injuries.
And what'll happen is, as the ball comes into play, the first thing it hits is the tips of the fingers. And when it does that, that's when you'll have a tendency to break a finger. So what we try and tell the kids is, as the ball is coming into your hands, open your hands completely. The ball should first strike the palm of your hand.
It's a lesson these two could have used before their very first games last season. Now, Laura Butita and Nicole Muth trade war stories on the bench.
This guy with a rocket for an arm caught the ball and whipped it hyperspeed at me, and I tried to catch it.
The force not only bent Laura's finger backwards, it broke a bone in her joint.
There's a very small fracture.
Orthopedic surgeon Dr. Mark Cohen was once a rec league 16-inch player himself. Now he puts other players' fingers back together. He sees about 20 to 30 softball injuries a season.
That looks like a very minor little injury, but that's actually a very bad injury. That means the finger actually dislocated and popped back.
Nicole Muth's injury was even worse.
And it was a lob. It was not forceful or anything.
That's the worst injury. That's the one we all dread.
But the ball made direct contact with the tip of her ring finger, driving the bone into the joint with extreme force, destroying it.
It's like an egg that explodes, an eggshell. So we actually rebuild this joint by taking part of a wrist bone. What other game do we catch projectiles, hard projectiles, with our fingers?
I don't know if I'll go back out, but I would love to cheer people on who play it and just tell them to be careful. And if a ball is coming at you at hyperspeed, you don't have to catch it. It's okay.
I was so excited to play, and I will never play again.
Nicole may be retiring, but it's safe to say the game will never die in the city where it was born.
Until I can't run anymore, then I'll keep on playing.
And they love the game so much, they still want to go out there. I mean, your arm could be hanging off, and you still want to, if you were playing third, you still want to try to go play third.
It's our game. It's Chicago-style softball. Once you start playing the game, it gets in your blood.
Safe!
Dr. Cohen says if you get a finger injury and can't make a fist after a day or two, you'll likely need an x-ray. You can learn more about 16-inch softball and the local Hall of Fame Museum on our website. Back to you.